Advertisement President Joe Biden issued a statement on Saturday evening, hours after former President Donald Trump's acquittal in his second impeachment. Today, 57 senators, including a record 7 Republicans, voted to find former President Trump guilty for inciting that deadly insurrection on our very democracy, Biden said, emphasizing that while the final vote did not lead to a conviction, the substance of the charge is not a get push notifications with news, features and more. Following you'll get the latest updates on this topic in your browser notification. Biden went on to note that even some Republicans who voted to acquit Trump, like Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell, still believe Donald Trump was guilty of a disgraceful dereliction of duty and practically and morally responsible for provoking the violence unleashed on the Instead of continuing to focus on Trump, Biden said that his thoughts were with all those who bravely stood guard that January. I'm thinking about all those who lost their lives, all those whose lives were threatened, and all those who are still today living with terror they lived through that day. And I'm thinking of those who demonstrated the courage to protect the integrity of our democracy, Democrats and Republicans, election officials and judges, elected representatives and poll workers, before and after the election. This sad chapter in our history has reminded us that democracy is fragile. That it must always be defended. That we must be ever vigilant. That violence and extremism has no place in America, and that each of us has a duty and responsibility as Americans, and especially as leaders, to defend the truth and to defeat the lie. As Biden's statement came to a close, he once again took a stand for the importance of working together to heal the nation. That is how we end this uncivil war and heal the very soul of our nation. That is the task ahead, and it's a task we must undertake together. As the United States of America, he said. Trump was charged with inciting an insurrection in January after a mob of his supporters stormed the U.S. Capitol during a joint session of Congress and 5 people died. The charges made him U.S. president to have been impeached twice. Along with all 50 Senate Democrats, Republican Richard Burr of North Carolina, Susan Collins of Maine, Bill Cassidy of Louisiana, Lisa Murkowski of Alaska, Mitt Romney of Utah, Ben Sasse of Nebraska and Pat Toomey of Pennsylvania voted guilty. Shortly after the Senate's decision, Trump released a lengthy statement, which was obtained by. He did not comment on the case made against him this week or acknowledge the accounts of mayhem and violence that were central to his Instead he complained, as he has numerous times over the years, of a witch hunt, and stated our historic, patriotic and beautiful movement to make America great again has only just begun. Following the vote, many celebrities spoke critically of what they just witnessed, with many pointing to McConnell's actions as being particular to those people governed by the 43rd Senate GOP who refused to convict. They do not care about your safety, the country's safety, or even their own, wrote Pat. They will go down in history as cowards and they don't deserve to The president was guilty of everything he was accused of. Which is why I voted to acquit, John Stewart wrote in another comment on McConnell, while Mia Farrow added in another, there's Mitch McConnell on my TV having his cake and eat. In another message, television host Jimmy Kimmel remarked on his disappointment over the outcome, feeling dumb, again, for hoping more of them would do the right thing,